Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good morning. So today we are going to present our IOT project, which is entitled Automated Shuttle Car. So next we move to the problems, our problem statement, which is the firstly, complexity. So existing IoT-based autonomous vehicle systems are often complex, posing a challenge for students to understand and implement. Second is limited accessibility. There is a need for more accessible and autonomous vehicle prototypes that can be used for educational purpose. And the last our problem statement is integration challenges, which is combining different components like sensor, cameras, and processing units into a cohesive and functional system can be difficult, requiring advanced technical knowledge and skills. Okay, for the objective for our project is we have two objectives, which is the first is to improve natural network to manage all the different data they encounter in cities. And the second is to enhance user satisfaction and convenience by providing a flexible and responsive shuttle service that meets the diverse needs of urban commuters.
Alright, right now I'm going to talk about circuit view. From this circuit, we can see that both DC motor is connected to our motor driver so that our motor driver can control both the DC motor, and there's a power supply that connected to motor driver to supply the power. And then there's a Raspberry Pi connected to motor driver, so it can control the motor driver to follow the line, so the car that can follow the line. And there's this little camera that you can see here that connected to Raspberry Pi. Cameras is to supply input to Raspberry Pi to process it so the car can follow the line.
Thank you, Faiz and Kevin. I will now explain how the car is working. So first of all, the camera captures an image, and then it will apply red perspective in order to give it a bird's eye view. And then we'll apply threshold image into the image in order to recognize the road itself and calculate the range of curvature. And last but not least, we generate an histogram to calculate whether the car is on the center of the road or does it require a turning.